a bell. Oh, hi kids. Welcome to Junior Supporters Club. Today is the biggest day of my life. Guess what? Sandy Roberts has asked me to go out and interview the Osmond Brothers. You know, the pop group, the Osmond Brothers, Donnie and Marie. It's going to be very exciting. That's why I've put on all my pop outfits today. The hat, the dark sunglasses. I tell you what, if I can get this job in the band, I'll be leaving the shores of Australia and become a big star overseas. The Osmond Brothers and KB. Sounds great, doesn't it? The young ones. I can hear them. Let's go and find them. The
young ones shouldn't be afraid.
Darling, we're the young ones.
Hey, who are you?
Kevin Bartlett, Junior Supporters Club. This is the biggest day of my life, meeting the Osmond Brothers. It's fantastic. It's a thrill of my lifetime, and I'd like to join your group.
The Osmond Brothers? We're the Osmond Brothers.
You're not the Osmond Brothers?
No.
The Osborne Brothers. What, you're not in a group? You're not in a band? You're not a singing group?
No, no, Kev. We're the Osmond Brothers in Fitzroy.
One more thing, Kevin.
Oh, and you loved every minute of it.
It was a lot of fun. And
now, am I
CNN, CNN are
syndicated?
Picking up the old Junior Supporters Club, and they're going to play it on the American cable network.
Was there bitterness when you found that you weren't accepted into a program, perhaps something like Country Practice? Was that a logical step?
Well, no, I wanted my own program to be absolutely correct. And you know, I hold Gordon Bennett totally responsible for the demise of Junior Supporters.
Well, he dumped it, didn't he?
He dumped it. We had 250,000 members on Junior Supporters Club, and went to
air. And that's not counting the international ones. You remember, of course, we had one major guest. Do you remember?
We did.
Well, can I refresh your memory?
We haven't got him, have we?
Let's have a look at this tape.
Fantastic, sir.
Thank you. Welcome, welcome not only to Australia, but to the Junior Supporters Club.
Well, thank you, Sandy, and thank you very much, Kevin, or as you're better known now in the States, KB. It's great to see you. I, I must say, I've watched your program with a lot of interest.
We sent you tapes originally, didn't we?
Yes, the tapes. I can tell you that sitting at the White House, that Nancy and I quite enjoy them. But now, of course, we have the special satellite dish.
Live.
Every Saturday night, as it is in the States, we enjoy Junior Supporters Club.
Fantastic.
Especially the star profile.
Yes, of course, that's what it all came from. That was, 8 years ago that the President was able to join us then. He was President of the United States.
Marvellous man.
And is still alive. Only last week he was at President Nixon's funeral. Mm. And this is something that you don't realise, and I'm having dreadful trouble here keeping a straight face. But he has decided, with Nancy, to fly down. He's here.
He's
Make
here.
Him welcome. Oh. The President is back.
Oh, he is
this
back.
Is fantastic. Oh.
Welcome, President. Welcome back.
Thank you, Mr. Reagan.
Welcome, Mr. Reagan.
It's wonderful to be here.
We know that you attended the funeral of the late Mr. Nixon and also caught up with the other presidents that are still alive.
I did, and it was good to see Jerry, George, and Jimmy again. And I may be seeing a little bit more of them, too, because...
What's happening?
We're the new four directors for the Richmond Football Club.
So,
KB, maybe I might be seeing a bit more of you, but after seeing the paper this morning, perhaps not.
Can I just talk about your time in office, Mr. President?
Yeah.
Because you officiated at so many major functions. I guess the one that would stand out for you would be the 1984 Olympics in Los Angeles. To have the Games in your own country must have been fantastic.
Sandy, it was wonderful, and I remember the opening ceremony very well when
you
I
spoke?
Got up there and read my speech. And
that was on an auto cue, wasn't it?
Yes.
The Porter prompt.
And I remember how it went. I got up there and I said, oh... Oh, oh, oh. And one of my aides came up and said, Mr. President, you're reading the Olympic rings.
Actually, speaking of your aides, I know too that you were one of the more popular presidents in days gone by and really kept your finger on the pulse, didn't you?
Well, one of my secretaries reminded me the other day when I saw him, he said, Mr. President, do you realize at one stage you were considered the least informed president in the United States history? And I said, I didn't know that.
Can I ask President Reagan, is it true that because Junior Supporters Club has been picked up on CNN and is going to be shown right across the cable network system, that you and Nancy have accepted the role as co-hosts for the program America?
We will be the international correspondents, KB, and I'm delighted to hear the news that you just broke exclusively there, that CNN is picking it up, and I can tell you that life for Nancy and I would not be the same without Junior Supporters Club,
well,
especially those star profiles.
You brought Nancy out with you. Where do you head now? Are you going straight back to America?
No, Sandy, we're going off to New Zealand for a bit of bungee jumping. Then we'll possibly pop into Honolulu for a bit of body surfing on the way back.
It's good to see you.
It's wonderful to be here.
Thank you, Mr. President.
KB, and the funny thing is, I just saw that clip before. I haven't changed a bit.
No, you have. What about...
You have.
Thank you very much, Mr. President, for joining us. All our best to your wife.
And Sandy's changed, of course, because he wears a toupee now, which he didn't do in those days.
You can't
course,
even see the joint, can you?
No, it's very, very good. It's one of the best ones.
Okay, that's enough. We've got to take a break. We're going to come back with some sanity. We're going to be talking State of Origin with another of the greats, Bob Skilton.
That's
oh, get the link!
I tip this.
Oh!